As an underwater photographer, especially if you're a scuba diver, you're probably very cognizant of the travel restrictions imparted by the airlines. Oftentimes here it's 50 pounds, but it can get down to as low as 30, depending on how remote your location is. So because of this, we've designed our large dome port to be as lightweight as possible. And you're going to want to use this large dome port if you're shooting wide angle, especially rectilinear lenses, to get the sharpest image possible. Now, one problem caused by this is that the large volume of air creates an increased buoyancy on the front end of the housing, so you'll notice it wanting to pull up. So the question is, how do you get a lightweight system, sharp images, and it be perfectly trimmed in the water? That's where this trim rail system comes in handy. So what you're going to do is you're going to take the rail and you're going to find a weight. So the weight's going to be dependent upon what lens you're shooting. How heavy is it? How long is it? How many port extensions there's going to be? But as a rule of thumb, I'll say 2 pounds is where I'd start. You can drop down to 1, you could go up to 3, but start there. You can always change it out later. And the best part is that these dive weights you're going to find on location. That means that's 3 pounds you don't have to fly with. Attaching it to the rail is very simple. Take the strap, the hook away from the center, put it up through. Grab your rail, put it up through the rail, back down through the rail. Back down through the weight. Through the buckle. Nice and snug. And then wrap it around and then back onto itself. Now that you have your weight attached to the rail, put it aside, grab your housing. When you flip it over, you're gonna notice there's a 1/4-20 threaded port on the bottom of the tray. So we're gonna take our rail. You're gonna grab your lobe screw and spacer. What this spacer does is it sits in between the tray and the rail because it lets the rail shoot underneath the dome port itself. So we'll take the knob on the top of the spacer, put it facing the weight, and then take your lobe screw in through the center hole of the spacer, and then this entire assembly will attach to that threaded hole on the tray. Now you'll notice a very long slot in the rail, and that's designed to allow you to take the rail and trim it back or forward depending upon the buoyancy that you desire in the water. That's it, no tools required, and you're set to get in the water. If you're shooting the big dome, trim it perfectly with the trim weight system. It's extremely easy. If you have any questions, comment below. Make sure to like and subscribe. Let us know any questions you may have.